I don't work with memory at all. I work with what I see in front of me. The only thing is that my language of painting is very idiosyncratic to me. So if I am painting you, then it won't be highly realistic, but it'll be my style of painting in a certain way. Initially, I was specifically interested in mundane images and things I saw around me, and I tried to log them or see them from my own perspective of how I'm viewing it. Then they started becoming images that I would see on the internet or something. Also because it was something we were compelled to do due to COVID. The screen time increased and that was the only source through which we could see things. I do have a love-hate relationship with the internet, like most of the people who use it and abuse it, and then they have an objective view about it too, that, you know, we're using it too much. Here I've displayed three sets of works. So the set of painting is called Synthetic Nature, and it's about me trying to redefine or define how I look at landscapes. So yeah, they are paintings, they are gouache on paper with pastel, and I chose some images which were clearly like landscapes, but then there were some which were just my personal choice of choosing a landscape, and I put them in this set of work. I was looking into landscape and then I was looking at these capture tests too. I was intrigued by the fact that how can you decide if you are a robot or a human through the selection of those images, and who is deciding these visuals, which are sometimes not even related to our cultural context. They are like signages which we don't see around us. So I realized, or I read, that we were doing these to help the AI to get better at understanding these images so that they can then make their categorization in an easier way, and we are in the end in a way helping Google. And the other two set of works, one is called Emotions as Shown by WhatsApp. I was like, okay, we started using emojis because we did not want to write our emotions, but now we have to again over explain it because the context keeps changing depending on who you are sending it to and where are you sending it from. I thought of using those images to actually teach humans how to show emotions. And I would always think that, okay, should I put this emoji here? What would it mean? Does it make sense? Is it too much? Is it okay to send this heart to somebody? So I started becoming self-conscious about images which were those emojis. And the last work is, I thought of having these quotes, which are again very popular in the internet right now, which is like, how to do this, how to do that. And I just made them also in a captcha format, which is written in a distorted text. They do escalate from something like, okay, how to manifest your perfect life, to then it goes to how to perfect yourself to death. So then it has that escalation.